flotation and sinking. A body floats in a liquid if its density is less than the density of the liquid, while a body sinks in a liquid if its density is more than the density of the liquid. Float, less dense than medium. Suspend, same density as medium. Sink, denser than medium. A metal object with a density of 7.86 grams per centimeter cube will sink in water, which has a density of 1 gram per centimeter cube, but will float on mercury, which has a density of 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. A small piece of cork will float on water because the density of cork is 0.25 grams per centimeter cube, which is less than the density of water, which is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Principle of flotation. When a body is immersed in a liquid, the following two forces act on it. 1. The weight of the body acting vertically downwards. This force has a tendency to sink the body. 2. The buoyant force of the liquid acting vertically upwards. The buoyant force is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed part of the body. This force has a tendency to move the body up. That is why buoyant force is also called upthrust. There are three possibilities. Case 1, weight of the body less than buoyant force, implies body floats on liquid, implies apparent weight of floating body is 0. Case 2, weight of body greater than buoyant force, implies body sinks in liquid, implies density of solid greater than density of liquid. Case 3, weight of body equal to buoyant force, implies body floats just inside the surface of liquid or hovers, implies apparent weight of body is 0, implies density of body is equal to density of liquid. Law of flotation. When a body floats in a liquid, the weight of the liquid displaced by its immersed part is equal to the total weight of the body. This is the law of flotation. That is, while floating, weight of the floating body is equal to weight of the liquid displaced by its immersed part, that is buoyant force. In other words, according to the law of flotation, the apparent weight of a floating body is 0. Some applications of flotation. 1. Flotation of an iron ship. An iron nail sinks in water, but a ship made of iron does not. This is because an iron nail is solid and the density of iron is greater than density of water. So an iron nail sinks in water. On the other hand, a ship is hollow, which makes the average density of the ship less than density of water. So the ship floats on water. 2. Flotation of a person. It is easier for a person to swim in sea water than in river water. The reason is that sea water contains dissolved salt, so its density is more than that of river water. The weight of a person gets balanced by less immersed part of the body in sea water as compared to that in river water. Hence, it is easier to swim in sea water compared to river water. 3. Flotation of ice on water. A piece of ice floats in water with 9/10 of its volume submerged in water and 1/10 outside the water. The reason is that the density of ice is 0.9 grams per centimeter cube, while that of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Hence, the weight of water displaced by 9/10 part of ice immersed inside water is equal to the weight of ice. 4. Submarine. A submarine is a watertight boat which can travel underwater like a ship. It can be made to dive or rise to the surface as and when desired. A submarine is provided with water tanks which can be filled with water to make the density of the submarine greater than that of seawater, and it sinks. When the water tanks are emptied, the average density of the submarine becomes less than that of seawater and it rises to the surface of water. 5. Icebergs. Very huge and large pieces of ice floating on seawater are called icebergs. Density of ice is 0.9 grams per centimeter cube and density of seawater is 1.02 grams per centimeter cube. Therefore, a large portion of iceberg remains submerged inside water and only a small portion floats above water. A ship can collide with the invisible part of iceberg under the surface of water, hence it is dangerous for ships. 6. Whales. Whales are sea animals that can rise or sink at their will. They have a special organ in their body which is called swim bladder. To come to the surface of water, they fill the bladder with air. This decreases the average density of the whale and so it rises to the surface. In order to dive into the sea, they empty the bladder. This increases the average density of the whale and so it sinks. 7. Balloons. A hydrogen or helium filled balloon rises in air. The reason is that the density of hydrogen and helium is less than the density of air. Therefore, the buoyant force experienced by the balloon due to the displaced air becomes greater than the weight of the balloon. Hence, the balloon rises up under the influence of the net upward force or upthrust.